brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyihi wa mustafa sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Brothers and sisters all over the world, welcome to another edition of your program, Correct Your Recitation. Before we begin with our actual program, inshallah, I'd like to welcome our studio guest, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, Umar, Ibrahim, Fahim, right? Thank you for joining us. And as usual, inshallah, we'll begin by listening to a beautiful recitation today of Surat Al-Ahqaaf from ayah number 21 through ayah number 28. It's one page, page number 505. A beautiful recitation by Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, inshallah. Then soon after that, we will study together some of these beautiful ayat. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, please, tafaddal.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. واذكر أخا عاد إذ أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم. قالوا أجئتنا لتأفكنا عن آلهتنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به. قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به ولكني أراكم قوما تجهلون. فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين. ولقد مكناهم في ماء مكناكم فيه وجعلنا لهم سمعا وأبصارا وأفئدة فما أغنى عنهم سمعهم ولا أبصارهم ولا أفئدتهم من شيء إذ كانوا يجحدون بآيات الله وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون. ولقد أهلكنا ما حولكم من القرى وصرفنا الآيات لعلهم يرجعون. فلولا نصرهم الذين الذين اتخذوا من دون الله قربانا آلهة بل ضلوا عنهم وذلك إفكهم وما كانوا يفترون.
ما شاء الله، بارك الله فيك، جزاك الله خيرا. Brothers and sisters, beautiful ayat from Surat Al-Ahqaaf from 21 through 28. We listen to their beautiful recitation. And these ayat come in succession after Allah the Almighty have discussed in details the concept of monotheism and proved with no doubt that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, have been sent by him. And he's a messenger that many messengers before him have been sent with the same message, which is to invite people to believe in the oneness of Allah the Almighty. And we also went through how Allah the Almighty refuted many of the common misconceptions that were raised by the Meccans, as well as people before them, again as their prophets and their messages, as well as people who would come afterward, like even nowadays. Today, inshallah, Allah the Almighty will take us in this ayat into a journey through the past to discuss what happened to nations before the Meccans and prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So in ayah number 21, Allah the Almighty says to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, وَذْكُرْ أَخَا عَادٍ, and mention and remember and share with people the story of أَخَا عَادٍ. أَخْ is a brother. عَاد is a tribe that used to live in a place which is known as Hadramaut, the southern part of the peninsula in Yemen particularly. And أخوهم, their brother, is Hud alayhi salam. أخوهم, he was their brother not due to religion or belief or faith. No, they actually opposed him and they belied him and denied his message. But the أخوه in this sense is the أخوه due to lineage, because he belonged to them. Allah the Almighty said, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا وَإِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. He sent to Ad one of whom? And he sent to the people of Thamud one of them. And so on, to every people, a prophet from them, whom they recognized him even before he was appointed with the prophethood, who spoke their language, was very familiar with their culture, with their practices. He is one of them. Not an angel that came down from heaven. Even when the disbelievers throughout the different eras and nations, they said, لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ مَلَكٍ. Why didn't Allah just send down an angel or supported him with an angel? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as in Surah Al-An'am, وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَهُ مَلَكًا لَجَعَلْنَهُ رَجُلًا وَلَا لَبَسْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَا يَلْبِسُونَ. If we were to send an angel as a messenger to communicate Allah's message to human beings instead of one of them, well, this angel, once again, has to look like one of them, has to speak their mother tongue, has to be behaving like them. So by the end, he would look like a human being. The only difference that they would not recognize him. He would appear as a stranger. Like when Jibreel alayhi salam visited the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the hadith which is collected by Imam Muslim and narrated by the great companion Umar ibn Khattab, he said, a man was wearing exceedingly white clothes with exceedingly black hair. He does not seem to be a traveler because he's not dusted, disheveled hair. No, he's neat. But yet we do not recognize him. So imagine an outsider, somebody from out of town, comes and invites you to something. What are you going to say? It would be more worthy to belie him and to disbelieve in him. But وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ. We have not sent a single messenger, but he spoke the mother tongue of his own people in order to explain to them clearly the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So أَخَى عَادٍ, the brother of Ad, a brother due to the lineage. He was from the tribe, from this town, from Hadramaut, from Yemen. What about Al-Ahqaaf? The word Al-Ahqaaf means the curved sand hills, and this surah was named after this term. It is the place in which the people of Hud alayhi salam, the tribe of Ad, lived. It was surrounded with curved sand hills, and we do have some images that we can look at so that we can comprehend what Al-Ahqaaf means. Curved sand hills in the southern part of the peninsula. Then the word An-Nuzur, plural of Nazir. It was not only Ad, he was not unprecedented. No, that before Ad, before Hud alayhi salam have come to Ad, and before Thamud, their prophet Salah have come to them, and before Lut have come to his people, there have been many prophets and many messengers, and after them many as well. And the seal of the prophethood was Muhammad, peace be upon him. وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرِ There have passed before Hud alayhi salam many prophets who have come with nuzur. And nuzur is plural of nazir. Nazir is a warner. And nuzur means the warners. The word لِتَأْفِكَنَا means to turn us away. عَنْ آلِهَتِنَا from our gods. They are not ashamed to say gods. There are many. Not only one. No, there are many. عَارِضًا means transversing. We would like to stop with the word bank up to this word. Then let's see. Inshallah, once we need another word, we'll get back to it. So, وَذْكُرْ أَخَا عَادٍ إِذْ أَنْذَرَ قَوْمَهُ بِالْأَحْقَافِ وَقَدْ خَلَتِ النُّذُرُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mention the story of Hud alayhi salam, Prophet Hud, who was the brother of Ad, from the tribe of Ad, in Hadramaut, were living surrounded with Al-Ahqaaf, the curved sand hills. What about them? Mention the story of Ad, and how they received the message of Hud alayhi salam, and the consequences of belying him and rejecting his message. Remember also in various chapters of the Qur'an, Allah the Almighty mentioned the story of Ad, the story of Thamud, the story of Lut with his people, but from different angles. You remember we studied in Surat Al-Fajr when Allah the Almighty said about Ad, he said, إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. And this is a very valuable information that historians could not verify on their own. Why? Most historians, ancient historians, think that the greatest ancient civilization was the pharaohs, the ancient Egyptian civilization. But the Quran says otherwise. The Quran in Surah Al-Fajr says, لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ. There was no other nation as powerful, as intelligent, as capable to do things, especially the architecture part, like the nation of Ad. And also in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Haq, فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةٍ سَخَرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا فَتَرَى الْقَوْمَ فِيهَا صَرْعَى كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَوِيَةٍ فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَقِيَةٍ. Great. So now we're talking about it's mentioned in Surat Shams, in Surat Al-Fajr, in Surat Al-Ahqaf, and in Surat Al-Haq. And you know that there is a whole chapter in the Quran which is known as Surat Hud alayhi salam. So also expect the story of Ad with their prophet Hud to be mentioned there. So from this angle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mention to them the story of Ad with their brother, one of them, Hud, Prophet Hud, whom I sent him to them. And as I said, he was not the first nor the last. لا وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه. يعني before him there have been many warners, and after him likewise there have been many warners. Warners here refers to whom? الرسل or الأنبياء, the messengers and the prophets, delivering the same message. What is the unity of the message of all the prophets here? أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Not to worship other than Allah. Not to associate with Allah any in worship. Why? إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Most surely, I fear for you the torment of a mighty day. You guys don't know. To you, it's totally unseen. And I'm here to warn you against it. I'm here to make you prepare for that day. Inni akhafu alaykum adhaba yawmin azim. How to be saved? Very simple. Very simple. And the hadith says that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, لَالْجَنَّةُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَىٰ أَحَدِكُمْ مِنْ شِرَاكٍ عَلَيْهِ. You know, paradise, heaven, which all of us longing for, is very near. How near? Is nearer to any of us than your own shoelace. Do you find any problem leaning over or leaning down in order to tie your shoelace? No. You want to bend over to tie your shoelace, untie it, you do that. Very simple, right? Al-Jannah is nearer and easier than that. Just say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Believe in the oneness of Allah, obey Allah, and abstain from his disobedience. You simply enter Al-Jannah. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. That is the ultimate success. So that was the message. Unity of the message of all the prophets. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Okay. قَالُوا أَجِئْتَنَا لِتَأْفِكَنَا عَنْ آلِهَتِنَا. Have you come with a new thing, with a new ideology to make a revolution, to turn us away from our faith, to disturb our belief, to take us away from our gods, لِتَأْفِكَنَا عَنْ آلِهَتِنَا. And in fact, yes. That is why Allah sent Hud alayhi salam and all the messengers to take people away from the worship of other than Allah, whether it's a stone or a human being or any creature other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So they accuse them that you have a hidden agenda. And that's why you're trying to turn us away from our gods. You know what? فَأْتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُنَا إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Just bring it on. You've been warning us. He's a warner. And he said, I fear for you the torment of عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. The torment of عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. So they say, just bring it on. فَأْتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُنَا. Why don't you just show us what you've been threatening us with? But he threatened you with hellfire. Just if you're telling the truth, bring it on. That is similar to another ayah in Surah Al-Shura, and Surah Al-Shura is chapter number 42, ayah number 18. Allah the Almighty said, يَسْتَعْجِلُ بِهَا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهَا. Umar, those who do not believe in the Day of Judgment, those who do not believe in life after death, they keep saying, bring it on. Show it to us. We're not afraid. Why? Because they don't understand how terrible it is. As far as for the believers, once the Day of Judgment is mentioned, they're frightened. They're shivering. Their hearts tremble with fear. Why? Because it is al-waqi'ah, it is al-sakha', it is al-tamma', it is al-haqa', it is al-qari'ah, these horrible, terrible names. People will be sorted out, and once you end up in somewhere, that's it. Either you are a believer and you'll be saved, or a disbeliever, and in this case, not a chance. Eternally in hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. We're talking about either an eternal delight in heaven or an eternal torment in hellfire. So they said, فَأْتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُونَ إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. How did he reply to them? He said, subhanallah, in ayah number 23. And before I quote the ayah and its meaning, every time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked, whether by his followers or by the Meccan pagans or even by angel Gabriel, peace be upon him, about when is it? When will it take place? Mata sa'a? What was his answer? Innama ilmuha 'inda Allah. Innama ilmuha 'inda Rabbi. La yujalliha liwaqtiha illa hu. Its knowledge is only with Allah. Neither the one who's asked nor the questioner knows anything about it. عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. So similarly, Hud alayhi salam replied to the challenge when they said, bring it on, we're not afraid of it. He said, قَالَ إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Hud alayhi salam, peace be upon him, also said that the knowledge, and here it refers also to the knowledge of the time of the Day of Judgment and the Hisab, is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُبَلِّغُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ. My role and my job is not to tell you when will it be at, when will it take place. No, I'm not authorized nor do I know anything about its time. My role is to tell you that you gotta prepare for it, to warn you against it, to deliver a specific message, which is Allah ta'budu illallah, inni akhafu alaykum عذاب يوم عظيم. I do not exceed my limits. وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به ولكني أراكم قوما تجهلون. But in fact, I see you guys show ignorance. You're belittling such great day, عذاب يوم عظيم. And this is a sign of what? Sign of ignorance. When some people, as it seems like it's a trend, and I personally believe that in the media, nothing happens haphazard. It's like a symphony. Even though they are rivals and competitors, but the secular media, whenever some stereotyping or false information is announced or, you know, published here or there, it echoes. Why? Because they orchestrate it together. So nowadays the trend is about denying the day of judgment and the torment of the grave and the torment of hell. Don't talk to us about that. God is love. This is even amongst Muslims, you know, and that is equivalent to disbelief. Okay, when somebody says, show me a proof, I'm not required, nor am I obliged to show you a proof, nor can I show you a proof, because if you don't believe in this proof, I don't have any other proof. Imagine all the prophets said, we don't know. We cannot show you a sign other than that. So what about me? When somebody says, oh no, we don't believe in any of that. We believe in God, and God is love, and God is mercy. Don't talk to us about the grave and hereafter and torment and fire and all of that. Everybody will go to heaven and say, okay, I don't have any means of giving you a tangible proof. But there is only one proof, is that inshallah, when you die, you're going to see it yourself. Why? Because it is entirely unseen. And if it is unseen, there is only one who can verify what is going to happen in the unseen, Allah. And if the information is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we just take it for granted and that's it. We don't argue with it. I mean, we argue with regards to the unseen. You know, in debate classes, people spend hours and hours debating over a pen, whether it's a pen or a pencil. Everybody knows it's a pen, but they argue for the sake of argument. Can you do the same with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Okay, argue. But for us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the prophets to cut it short. وَأُبَلِّغُكُمْ مَا أُرْسِلْتُ بِهِ. I don't know anything about its time. I cannot promise you anything. Well, I can tell you that it will happen. And you'll be resurrected. And you'll be held accountable. And this is my message to you. وَلَكِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ قَوْمًا تَجْهَلُونَ. You're showing ignorance. Okay. So they belied him. They denied his message. And now they were ready for the consequence, which is the torment. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقَبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم. Then when they saw the torment, now they don't know it's the torment. They saw something looks like a dense cloud. Actually, it was very dark. And the darker is the cloud, the good news, the more good news people expect. That means it's very dense. It carries a lot of water. And it will bring a lot of rain. So when they saw a dense cloud coming towards their valley in Hadramaut, they said, "Ah, هذا عارض ممطرنا." This is a cloud that we've been waiting for so long. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicted them with a drought, no rain, for so long, for several days. And now, after this drought, they saw the cloud. It was very dense, it was very dark. So they expected mercy in it. And it was nothing but the means of torment. And عذاب والعياذ بالله. They celebrated the cloud. And when they sensed the wind, they were delighted and they were celebrating that we will receive the rain. But they don't know. It was the means of their utter destruction. You know, Aisha radiallahu anha, and the hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari or Muslim. She said, whenever we would experience wind or would see the clouds, the Prophet ﷺ's face will turn red and it will be colored and he would seem very worried and he will go back in and out and back and forth and he will be very worried. So once I said, O Prophet of Allah, whenever people see the clouds or find the wind, they celebrate because this is a sign of having rain. And it means a lot to us, life. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to her, Ya Aisha, وَمَا يُدْرِينِي And what will make me sure that it is not a means of torment? What happened with the people of Ad? They saw the cloud coming, dense. So they said, هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَا This is a cloud carrying plenty of rain. بَلْ هُوَ مَا اسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ No, it is not the means of mercy. It is not the rain that you were waiting for. It is what you've asked for. What did they ask for, Umar? They said, bring it on. Show us the punishment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivered. In what looked like the means of mercy, which is the wind and the clouds. You know, nowadays, we've been experiencing severe winds in the Middle East, in the whole Middle East, and severe cold weather, and even snowstorm, right? Some people, because the weather is very cold, all of us are wearing heavy coats and, you know, heavy clothes in order to gain some warmth. And some people curse the wind and curse the weather. Why? Because it's affecting their business or they feel cold. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تسبوا الريح فإنها من روح الله. Don't you curse the wind. It is from the spirit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what should we do? Al-Bukhari Muslim collected the hadith that whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would see the wind, he would say, اللهم إني أسألك خيرها وخير ما فيها وخير ما أرسلت به وأعوذ بك من شرها وشر ما فيها وشر ما أرسلت به. We studied before in Surah Thamud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ None knows the host of your Lord but Him. الريح is one of the hosts of Allah. In Surah Al-Haqqa, Allah explained in details how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala utilized the wind to utterly destroy the people of Ad. To the point that you could see nothing of their traces. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ They were utterly destroyed except for some of the traces of their homes. I hope we have some images of the homes of Ad, the curved sand hills. If we have them, can we display them, please? And some of the images of the remains of their homes, much more advanced than the pharaohs and their civilizations, but they were utterly destroyed. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ خَاوِيَةٍ You know, when a dead palm tree dies or gets burned, and you only see the trunk, and it is empty from inside, hollow. So they were like that, like so. Can you imagine? Because of the wind, that what happened to them? They were utterly destroyed. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَقِيَةٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it upon them, as Allah said in Surah Al-Haqqa, سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ وَثَمَانِيَةَ أَيَّامٍ حُسُومًا Seven nights and 8 days consecutive, non-stop, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask Allah the Almighty, Oh Allah, I ask you, its goodness. And the goodness which it was sent with what? You know that there is an angel who is in charge of the wind and the clouds. His name is? Mikael. In charge of the rain. But also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could speed up the wind just a little bit. Just a little bit. And it can destroy not just a nation or a country, it can destroy the whole world. Whenever there is a little hurricane or tornado, people have to evacuate. They are not worried about their Mercedes or their, you know, very expensive houses or the neighborhood. They just run away. They leave. I myself, amongst hundreds of thousands of other Americans, had to run away from one city to another because it's no joke. It utterly destroys everything. And life is better than any other possession or properties. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us, and look at those images. This is, can you imagine, that was thousands and thousands of years ago? Great architecture. Subhanallah. That was even before the pharaohs and their civilizations. And what happened to them? فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ They used to carve their homes within the mountains. Allah gave them knowledge. Allah gave them power and ability and faculties of hearing and senses. They were much greater than any other nation. As he said, التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد. There was not a single nation better than, as far as their capacities and capabilities, than the nation of Ad. Yet, it did not avail them an art. Again, is the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the cloud was approaching and they were celebrating, it was nothing but the severe wind which utterly destroyed them, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained when he said, بَلْ هُوَ مَسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ. No, it is not the rain. It is not the mercy. Rather, it is what you've been asking for. You rushed it. You said, bring it on. Okay. استعجلتم به. ريح فيها عذاب أليم. Violent wind that contains a torment which is very severe. A severe and a painful torment. Okay. Very important information. Every time in the Quran, the word ريح is mentioned. If you read it in English, it says wind. And رياح means wind. But when Allah uses the term ريح, it refers to torment. ريح وأرسلنا الرياح لواقح. Beautiful. الرياح means of mercy. But الريح means of punishment and torment. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم. It destroyed everything by the leave of its Lord. Whose Lord? The wind's Lord. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا. It's just one of the servants of Allah. So he sends it mild or violent to destroy. فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُرَى إِلَّا مَسَاكِنُهُمْ. After math, there was nothing remaining but some of their houses, as we saw some of the images. كَذَلِكَ نَجِزِ الْقَوْمَ الْمُجِرِمِينَ. You know, brothers and sisters, the following ayah is talking about that Ad were given much more faculties and capabilities greater than Quraysh. Yet it did not avail them an art. Again is the torment of Allah. Ya Quraysh, O Meccan people, you're very weak and vulnerable. You build your homes of mud. You better fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his torment, because you already heard about what happened to Ad. And you heard about what happened to Thamud, the villages around you in ayah number 27. And to the people of Lot in Jordan. You're aware of all of that in the neighborhood. You have to be very careful. But in vain. The advices and the warning of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to most of them increase them nothing but rebelliousness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to what is best. I would say that we'll stop at ayah number 25 in the sharh. And inshallah to be continued in the next episode. But we're going to take a short break so that we can enjoy reciting together these ayat. Inshallah, in the next segment, please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Welcome again from me, from your host Ismail Bullock, and from your host
Gabriel Romain. The parents have to encourage their kids to get married, and at the same time, support them. Yeah.
What many people don't understand is that seeking knowledge in itself is ibadah. And Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, لَأَنْ أَطْلَبُ الْعِلْمَ سَاعَةً أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَلْفِ رَكَعَةً. That I seek knowledge for an hour is better and more beloved than Alf raka, which means 1,000 raka.
The real meaning of La ilaha illallah is not there's no God but God. La ma'bud bihaqqin illallah. That is, if you want to note it down, that is the real meaning of La ilaha illallah. There is none worthy of worship except Allah.
I remember as a Christian, when I was a Christian before, you know, they have this whole issue of you know, your cross, you know, you have to wear your cross, this will protect you, and if it breaks, you know, something wrong will happen to you, and, you know, the icons, and, you know, put an icon in your wallet. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Recited TV's social media sites are the best way to contact us from anywhere around the world. Stay connected with Huda TV's latest news and programs through Facebook, Twitter, Google+, YouTube, Skype, and Instagram. It's fast and easy. Stay up to date with your favorite shows and scholars today. Huda TV, a light in every home.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. Our phone numbers are 002-0125-008679. Alternatively, 002-0100-246-4583, and the email address is tajweed@huda.tv. Barakallahu feekum. Now we're ready to receive your calls for those who would like to recite this ayat from 21 through 28, inshallah, live. While waiting for your calls, inshallah, I'll begin with our studio guest, Omar. Assalamu alaikum. Ready to recite from ayah number 21, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wadhkur akha 'adin in anzara. واذكر أخا عاد إذ أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه ألا تعبدوا إلا الله وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ.
Okay, can you hold on please? Sister Aisha from the KSA, assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum
salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Go ahead, Sister Aisha, recite from ayah number 21, that is page 505.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واذكر أهاعد إذ أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد فلت النذور من بين يديه ومن خلفه الله تعبدوا إلا الله إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم. قالوا أجئتنا لتعفكنا عن آلهتنا فأتنا بما تعيدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به ولكني أراكم قوما تجحدون. فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرون بل هو ما استعجلتم به.
قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا
بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب عليم. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين.
Sister Aisha, can you say again the last passage of the previous ayah, ayah number 24? ريح فيها عذاب أليم.
ريح فيها عذاب عليم.
That's why I asked you to repeat it. Because just imagine you said عذاب. So you pronounce the first letter of the word عذاب as عين. عذاب. But it is not right to say عليم as well. Because the meaning has been changed completely. Now it is أليم. عذاب أليم. No problem. Inshallah, I hope you got the notice and you keep it in mind. Even though those six letters are known as the throat letters, halqi letters, but they have different articulation points, upper part, lower part, middle part. So if we confuse the hamza with the ayn, for instance, it would definitely change the meaning. So عذابٌ أليم, the word أليم describes the torment. It's very painful. But عليم, what has happened? The only letter that I change is the hamza. I mispronounced it. I said عليم instead of أليم. Has the meaning changed? Of course. عليم means knowing, knowledgeable. Okay? بارك الله فيكم. Continue please, يا عمر. آية 22. قالوا أجئتنا.
قالوا أجئتنا لتأفكنا عن آلهتنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به ولكني أراكم قوما تجهلون فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين ولقد مكناهم فيما إن مكناكم فيه وجعلنا لهم سمعا وأبصارا وأفئدة وجعلنا لهم سمعا وأبصارا وأفئدة فما أغنى عنهم سمعهم ولا أبصارهم فما أغنى عنهم سمعهم ولا أبصارهم ولا أفئدتهم من شيء إذ كانوا يجحدون بآيات الله وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون.
حسبك بارك الله فيك. Sister Zaina from Nigeria, assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Go ahead, sister, and recite from ayah number 21, the beginning of page 505, please.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم قالوا أجئتنا لتأفكنا عن آلهتنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به أراكم قوما تجهلون فلما رآه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا
Again Zainab فلما رأوه again
نعم
Again this ayah فلما رأوه
فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين.
حسبك جزاك الله خيرا بارك الله فيك استاذنا. Very good ما شاء الله. Sheikh Abu Bakr Shatri has many fans, mashallah. Ibrahim, please continue from ayah 26. وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ.
أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي مَاءٍ مَكَّنَّاكُمْ فِيهِ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ سَمْعًا وَأَبْصَارًا وَأَفْئِدَةً وأفئدة فما أغنى عنهم سمعهم ولا أبصارهم ولا أفئدتهم من شيء إذ كانوا يجحدون بآيات الله وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون. ولقد أهلكنا ما حولكم من القرى وصرفنا الآيات لعلهم يرجعون. فلولا نصرهم الذين اتخذوا من دون الله قربانا آلهة بل ضلوا عنهم وذلك إفكهم وما كانوا يفترون.
حسبك بارك الله فيك. فهيم from the beginning please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. واذكر أخا عاد إذ أنذر قومه بالأحقاف وقد خلت النذر من بين يديه ومن خلفه ألا تعبدوا إلا الله ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم. قالوا أجئتنا لتأفكنا عن آلهتنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال إنما العلم عند الله وأبلغكم ما أرسلت به ولكني أراكم قوما تجهلون. فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا.
Can you start over?
فلما رأوه عارضا
دراء has فتحة فلما رأوه
فلما رأوه عارضا مستقبل أوديتهم قالوا هذا عارض ممطرنا بل هو ما استعجلتم به ريح فيها عذاب أليم. تدمر كل شيء بأمر ربها فأصبحوا لا يرى إلا مساكنهم كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين.
حسبك يا فهيم بارك الله فيكم. Actually we ran out of time brothers and sisters, but I would like before we wrap it up that we should make dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our brothers and sisters who are refugees in camps on the borders of many countries, particularly the Syrian refugees, in millions of them. Since we're talking about the wind, and we all know that how cold is the weather, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send down the warmth upon them, protect them, provide for them, and soften the hearts of the Muslim ummah and the Muslim leaders particularly, to have mercy on them. to shelter them and to assist them at this time of need and during this crisis. Similarly, Muslim brothers and sisters in Gaza, in Burma, in Myanmar, and in many places, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save this ummah and protect it from every evil. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.